I'd like to rewrite each expression in radical form. So x raised to the 2/3 can be written as the cube root of x squared. That's one option. Another option would be the cube root of x and everything is squared. Either of these two answers are correct. For the next expression, the 9, this is a little tricky. A lot of people tend to raise the 9 to the negative 2/3, but this 9 is separate. It's really saying 9 times x to the negative 2/3. So the 9 we're going to put out here by itself. Now, the x to the negative 2/3, well, what's our base? Our base is x. To get rid of the negative exponent, we take the reciprocal of our base. So instead of x, it's going to be 1 over x, and now we make the exponent positive. So to finish, we have 9 times 1 is 9, all over x to the 2/3. Now, to finish up, we want to take this and make this into radical form, the x to the 2/3. So we have 9 over x, and it's the cube root of x squared. And again, you could also write this as 9 over the cube root of x, and then square everything. So let me just circle that. Either of these two answers are correct. 9 over the cube root of x squared, or 9 over the cube root of x, and then you square that quantity. Last but not least, again, this 7 is really saying 7 times x to the negative to the positive 2 over 5. So the 7 is not being raised to the 2 over 5 power. So we have 7 times the 5th root of x squared, which equals 7 5th root of x squared. Again, this squared you can put on the outside. You could have 7 times the 5th root of x and square this quantity. So either of these two answers are acceptable.